Hi YouTube family, my name is Elysia English and today is sweater weather. It's so chilly here, but the sun is just coming out and it's getting us to gear up for some projects that we need to tackle around the house for fall. We are about probably 3 weeks away from needing our fall jackets and a lot of our mitts and gloves and things that really fill up our entryway closet. And on our journey to becoming more minimalist, Philip and I are trying to design some spaces around the house so that everything that we have in our home actually has a space. And so tackling a very important spot on our house, our front entryway, is really going to make an impact on how efficient and functional our winter coats and gear are going to be for our family this year. And so I have kind of like two passions right now. I love trash to treasure. We all are in the trash to treasure crew here, but I also love minimalizing and organizing our home. And it's something that I'm becoming more and more passionate about as my life gets busier. For example, on YouTube, it's really more important for me now than ever to have a very functional, easy working household where we kind of know where everything is. These two passions of mine this week have kind of collided together because I found the perfect trash to treasure item on the side of the curb this week that was going to help me with minimalizing our front entryway closet and making it a lot more functional. What a lucky find. I just went to go get some errands and I had to stop because I saw this cute cart on the side of the road. I know for sure what I'm gonna do with this. It's gonna be perfect for a project that I wanna work on this week. And if you missed this week, we tackled an extreme makeover on our entryway and spent less than $50 transforming that space. And the only thing left to do now in that space is to work on that closet. Closets are so important, especially your entryway, because what do you do when you come in your door? You come in and you need to unload all of the things that you've taken out with you, your purse, your jacket, your shoes, a mask, all of these things, and you need to have a spot for them. Otherwise, they're just on the floor or got tossed on a side chair, maybe even on your couch, dining room table chair, and it doesn't really give you that open and like put together and organized space. And so when you also walk in and someone comes as a guest and you open that dreaded front door closet, you don't want it to be a disaster. How embarrassing, right? So we're gonna tackle this closet today and use our trash or treasure find to make this space a lot better for our family.
So let's talk vision of the closet space. Since we don't have a large entry, function is the key element to making this space work what is going to be the best way for our family and have storage for everything that we need. And since we live in Ontario, we definitely have a lot of winter gear. So I wanna make sure that I keep in mind everything that we're gonna need to store in this space. Hats, mitts, snow pants, winter boots, extra gloves and hats, so many things that we're going to need. And so let's talk about the vision on what this is going to look like. So this is the closet. It lacks all function. There's no storage in here whatsoever other than a bar to be able to hold your jackets on hangers. And so since we have little kids, it doesn't really work that well. They don't always have an actual hanger or want to hang up their jacket on this. They prefer an easier hook than actually struggling with a hanger. So what I want to do is make this so much more functional, add baskets, add ledges for shoes, and actually have everything labeled in this space. And then also have room in this closet to switch over for seasonal. Because we have four seasons, we have different types of jackets for different seasons. And then where do you put those when it's not in season? I don't really want to pack them away in a basement or something. So I really want to think about how this can be an interchangeable space based on the season. So actually for the past 5 years that we've owned this house, we haven't really utilized this closet because there was actually styrofoam on all of these walls that are lower here. We just removed this bottom part so I could show you what we didn't know was hiding behind. It's always felt like it was soft wall and that we really couldn't hang any shelving. Well, when we were doing our entryway the other day, we discovered that it's not just styrofoam. So we're going to remove the rest of this styrofoam. And this is a hanger, which is actually super useful, but really more or less just for Philip and I's clothes. And so we wanna hang this up taller, giving us this space lower from when coats would hang to about here to create some shelving and utilize that trash and treasure that I just found and do those baskets in a color and then label them so each of us have a basket. There's four baskets, there's four of us, it works out perfectly. And then have a spot to be able to rotate our coats and jackets, color code them and switch them for the seasons. We're going to get outside right now, clean up that trash or treasure that we found and revamp it, build our shelving. I'm going to make this bar here a different color. Philip's gonna move up this shelf so it's a lot taller. And we're gonna make this a really functional space.
That's better than it was.
Yeah, no, that looks good.
Sticker or something.
I would love to wash these in my bathtub with a little bleach and water, but we currently don't have a bathtub installed because it's now in the driveway because of our bathroom renovation. So minor setback. So we're going to use some dish soap instead and the hose outside and get these super clean. And then I'm going to spray paint these baskets gold. I've decided that I'm not going to use the base, that I'm just going to utilize the baskets. Still worth it for me to have picked this up on the side of the road because these are great storage baskets.
Color the bar is gonna be
green.
There's a pattern, Phil. Keep up. There's a pattern.
hold on. Gold.
Gold.
Oh yay.
Okay. Let's see. Oh.
Oh, it goes smaller.
No, there's a hook. Yeah, there's a hook on either end.
Oh, go spray. Oh, I'm too short.
That there. Short girl problems. Well, that was easier.
Oh, this is Dayton. Says Dayton on the ledge.
Aww.
Oh, he made me a flower one day and a gaming piece. Not surprised it's a game piece with Dayton's work. Oh, sorry.
That's okay. I'm kind of loving all the demolition lately. It's good to get it, all that pent up frustration from the weekend. I don't have any pent up frustration. It's just great to break stuff.
So Philip's getting out all of these side rails, any hardware, anything that's in the space. That way we can fill all of the holes. So if you look up at the upper top of the shelf here, underneath, there's tons of holes from all the stuff that the previous owners had drilled onto everything. And I want to get that super smooth before I start painting. Okay, so the other day when I was putting, It took almost 24 hours for all my putty to dry just because of the temperature outside. I don't want this to take forever.
No.
Those are the only two like super deep spots.
That I just made.
Yes. Spider friend. Yeah, all the big holes are the ones you just made.
But I got that wood out of there.
You did. That bird's got a whole lot to say to you. Walk with the animals, talk with the animals. Tip for spraying screws, stick them in some styrofoam or a cardboard box and then you can get the heads really easily without having to flip them over.
It is a race against time right now. We have two cuts we have to do. And Elysia's trying to get the last coats of spray paint on right now before this storm rolls in.
We've been gearing up the first storm the last couple days though. Holy. We kind of knew it was gonna happen, but I was hoping not today.
Oh my gosh, hurry up, hurry up.
It's the cloud.
I know, it's not good.
Oh man. Somebody painted the grass gold.
Bling, bling, baby.
That was a close one. We almost didn't accomplish that.
Okay, get in.
It's a freezing cold rain.
Yeah, it's cold. It's gonna be a cold storm.
Trash to treasure, literally.
Okay, YouTube family, this is Elysia and I's favorite thing right now. Ready?
Sitting on the screened-in porch during a thunderstorm, It's the little things in life that make life so much more enjoyable. When Philip and I were first dating, we spent some time at a cabin in the summer, and without a doubt, every summer when we went, a couple of the days while we were there, it would rain. So we would just sit on this enclosed in porch that they had at the cabin and look out on the lake and listen to the rain. And so it always reminds us of just like nice cuddle up in the couch or at the cabin, listening to the rain and just relaxing. And we would always fall asleep out there. So this is our favorite spot to sit when it rains.
I'm doing 16 inches up all the way around the perimeter in the inside of the closet to put my first shelf, and then use my level to put my first board on. And I'm using some 1x2s. I cut them longer, but they will be behind, and then my ply would be on top. So it'll be around the perimeter of this. That way I'll have something to actually drill into in addition to the wall. And then I'll be able to do a wood trim around the front. So I've pre-cut all of my pieces and I'm ready to put on my first shelf. Super fun. I'm ready to put my first cut shelf on. I made those ledges and I'm ready to put this on top, and then I can screw a few screws around the perimeter at the top.
Occasionally, I need to breathe. Stop me for a second.
Looks amazing.
Occasionally, I set them free. Don't hold me back now, I'm in the lead. This partial life. This partial life. What a time to be alive.
I'm excited to show you what the inside of the closet looks like now. I stayed up super late, did tons of coats of white paint, which is kind of the boring part, but I was able to transform this closet into a functional space using my curbside find, some gold spray paint, and some leftover plywood. I had to think of what the other ingredient was. Gold spray paint, curbside find, and some leftover plywood from the studio, and I was able to transform this entryway. I decided to make some really cute tags last night once I got done painting and while I was waiting for paint to dry. I think they turned out super cute. This is now a completely gone through closet. We're going to be pulling out our winter gear, but we actually purged through about 80% of what was already in this closet before we even put our winter stuff in. So we are really ahead of ourselves in minimalizing what we're going to have for our four seasons. So here is the closet.
I've been feeling so small. Watch the clock ticking off the wall.
The curbside find was the perfect addition to put into this closet. It means that all four of us have a basket to put our own belongings, like hats, mitts, wallet, whatever we want to put in our personal basket. And so I actually used some Scrabble tiles and just some little piece of gold wire and put our names. So each of us have our little tag on the front of our basket, and then our stuff for our coats is hanging just above our basket. I found the tiniest little boy jackets that the boys actually just wore in the spring or even just last fall. And I thought, oh my gosh, how did they even wear these within this year? Because they've grown so much. So just purging out things that no longer fit or maybe weren't in perfect condition that we didn't really want to keep or we'd kind of overworn. Getting that all out of the closet made a huge difference in minimalizing the inventory that we have in this closet space. We raised up this bar and painted the bar gold, so I can actually put more baskets of seasonal up there. So I plan on finding a couple of just thrifted baskets that I can label spring, summer, fall, and winter. Since we have four seasons, there's a few items that we can put in there that we don't need to have displayed as our inventory all the time. So we have all of our jackets now all purged out. They all fit. They're all usable jackets that we wear. We all have our own basket. And then we have plenty of more room here to put shoes and extra baskets if we find other items that we need to put in our closet. So there's so much more room in this closet than we even need now that we've purged out all of the stuff that we really don't use. We can put so much more in this closet, and this closet was jam-packed full. So we really are now utilizing this space, and we actually don't probably even have enough things to fill up this closet anymore now that we're minimalizing. But that's the point of this, is just to having the items that we actually use bring value to our life and to keep our house a lot more organized. So the other thing that I really wanted to add to this space was a spot for us to put our clean masks, spot to put our dirty masks. And so I've actually added a garbage pail into the closet here just in the corner that the kids can dump, almost like a little mini laundry hamper that they can throw their mask in when they come in the house. And then I know that I can grab that every couple days and throw it in the wash. Usually throw the mask in with other small little items and make sure that they get a fresh pile put back in our entryway. And so this is just a nice way to have a little spot for the dirty ones to go. And then we also have a bin of clean wash masks. And then the boys also like to wear these other fabric face covering hoo rags. So we have baskets for both of them to go, some for everybody. If they have one that they really want to wear that day, they can have it in their basket also. So there's lots of options. I also thought that it was perfect because hats are really hard to display, and all of my boys, including Philip, wear ball caps. So now they can just throw their hat that they're wearing at that time in their basket. Keeps it off of the floor. So the boys aren't really always using the hangers, and I know that they struggle with hangers all the time, especially with heavy winter jackets. And so I love that when we did the makeover in the entryway here, we were able to create these pegs on the wall, so when they come in and they have just a sweater, they can just hang it on this hook. They don't have to struggle with the hanger. So we also have this option, but much more inviting now if we have guests over and we want to hang up their jacket. There's extra hangers in here. You could just open it up. The closet looks inviting and you can hang up a jacket. So much better than the disastrous overflowing closet that we had before. All of this stuff that we used for this project was completely upcycled. The only thing I had to purchase was the spray paint. So for only about $8.99, I was able to transform this entire entryway. Doing entryways is a great way to start doing home renovations and kind of dabble in getting your house more organized. Having an organized entry makes the rest of your house stay a lot more cleaner in your front rooms. Thank you so much for watching. I love having all of your support. I love you, and I will see you on the next video.